Hi friend, today we'd like to share with you about topic of devout. What is a devout person? Devout person is a deeply religious, devoted to particular religion, loyal to something, devoted to a particular belief, organization, person, etc. Serious and sincere. What is devout Catholic? Definition: devout, that dedicated to religion or sincere. An example: devout is a Catholic who has unending faith in God, attend Mass every Sunday, and follow all the practices. What is a devout soul? To be devout, to be deeply devoted to one religion or to another belief, cause, or way of life. If you reading this, you probably a devout believer in improving your vocabulary. How do you use devout in a sentence? Number one, person are very devout. Number two, he was very devout and his model were irreproachable. Number three, his diary is therefore valuable chronicle of contemporary events from the standpoint of moderate politician and a devout adherent of the Church of England. What are characteristics of a religious person? Data analysis also imply that basic religious beliefs have positive correlation with the agreeableness, good nature, soft-hearted, selfless, sympathetic, forgiving characteristics, extraversion, sociable, fun-loving, a passionate, talkative, and joyful characteristics. What do you call a person who believes in all religion? Omniscience is a recognition of respect all religion, or lack thereof. Those who hold deep belief are called omnis. Many omnis say that all religion contain truth, but that no one religion offer all that is truth. Can a person be spiritual but not religious? Being spiritual but not religious means you do not need a church or a community. Some say, a bit you do, I'm spiritual but not religious. Interchangeably, fair people often use to divide their belief that they don't need organized religion to live a life of faith. What does it mean to be a spiritual person? Seven spiritual needs. Spirituality is a broad concept with room for many perspectives. In general, it includes a sense of connection to something bigger than ourselves, and it typically involves a search for meaning in life. As such, it's universal human experience, something that touches us all. How can I improve my spiritual life? Seven ways to improve your spiritual health. Number one, applaud your spiritual score. By applauding your spiritual score, you simply ask yourself questions about the person who you are and your meaning. Number two, look for deeper meaning. Number two, get it out. Number four, try all yoga. Number five, travel. Number six, think positively. Number seven, take time to meditate. How do I pray to God for a miracle? Number one, take time to remember how much God loves you and those you are praying for. Number two, remember all the way God has been faithful in the past. Number three, pray the words. Number four, be comfortable, not knowing what to pray. Number five, invite others to pray with you. Number six, find peace in surrendering to God's will. Number seven, worship God. Is it good to be a God-fearing? Fearing God actually one bad characteristic of good Christian, because it saves us from caving into our own sinful nature. That's why hearing that someone is a God-fearing actually makes us trust that person more. If they fear God, they are more likely to keep their words and treat others with kindness. How do you show devotion to God? Do random acts of kindness. Do good things. Jesus said, If you love me, you will keep my commandment. Honor God's name, do it by helping people to believe in God, and by sending message of hope to order and create them. Remember, subscribe to see the next video. Thank you.